Hey, what's going on, guys? Little update on the 350z. I meant to take you guys along for the ride yesterday, but I totally forgot my camera. We ended up waking up at 7:30 in the morning to drive a couple towns over and pick up an engine. If you saw the last video, you'll know it has a rod knock in it and it doesn't stay running. I think that's probably due to compression issues. So we jumped on Craigslist, ended up finding an engine that was supposedly running, has 117,000 miles on it. So we drove out there and picked it up. I'll show you guys what it looks like. Sorry for the mess. We've been working on a lot of projects, specifically tearing this 350Z down. So we got stuff everywhere. But here's the engine. It looks pretty clean. That doesn't really say too much until we get the other one ripped out and put in. But we fit this thing in a 2000 Jeep Cherokee. So that was a little scary, but we got it here. These engines weigh about 300 pounds. And getting it in and out of the car was probably the hardest part. I've never done this before. First time using an engine hoist, so. The guy that gave us the engine was super cool. It came with all the coil packs. Came with the throttle body, threw in the AC compressor. We already have that, so we might just sell that. Ended up coming with the clutch too. And the pressure plate, came with the injectors. Came with these headers too, they're stock headers. The engine mounts. Pretty much everything even came with the wiring harness. That's the complete engine wiring harness, so we'll have a spare for that too. All the little sensors came on it. So I'm pretty stoked to get this thing in and see if the car runs. So the next step's gonna be pulling the engine out of the 350Z. So if you guys wanna keep updated with that, like and subscribe to the channel. I also got a bunch of parts coming in for the Subaru, so we're gonna start a new little upgrade series on that one. It'll just be a couple episodes, so. Stay tuned, guys. Thank you.